Pásale, Humberto. Lucas. Ok, señores, les di las instrucciones ahí abajo. Los dos traen el calzón un poquito alto, así que aquí, para los dos está perfectamente bien. Dense la mano, buena suerte a los dos.
Vámonos.
The fifth round scheduled for 10 for the vacant WBC Continental America's title in the super lightweight division. Lucas Matisse of Argentina in the baby blue. And Humberto Soto in the metallic and gold shorts. And we are joined by super bantamweight world champion Abner Mares, who's just coming off a win over Eric Morrell as he moved up in weight. Abner, thank you very much for joining us. What do you think thus far of these two men?
My pleasure. Great to be here. And what can I say, man? This is a great fight. It's barely the fifth round, and oh my God, I'm already tired of seeing these guys throw so much, man.
Reminds us of you against Yanni Perez or Joseph Egbeko. Both men doing what they do well. You know, Soto using his hand speed and Matisse using his power and his body punching.
I think they're both doing they're sticking to their game plan. Soto is a great technician, great fighter, but Matisse is just so strong and so confident with that, you know, with that, he's confident with that hard punches that he's got.
Abner, you are a body puncher yourself, and Matisse in this fight here in the fifth has delivered a lot of left hooks to the body on Soto. When does it really start paying dividends when you continue to go to the body on your opponent?
Definitely after the sixth round. I mean, it's already, you can already tell Soto's already clinching. You can tell on his face he's feeling those body shots.
You know, this round, Soto's done some very good work, but we've still got a minute and 19 left, and you made the point. Look, there he goes with those good combinations, but Matisse always comes back with something strong, like that.
Yeah, but I mean, Soto, he lets go, but, you know, he stays there. He stays there for Matisse to come back with something hard.
And that's been the problem for Soto in these wars that he gets in, like the fight with Antione. It's a really good round.
Right uppercut. There's another left hook to the body. Look at the deep breathing by Soto. Mouth open. Left hook.
Oh my.
Matisse again, heavy punching.
Matisse is the best body puncher in South America and one of the best body punchers in boxing. And he's showing it tonight.
As Abner Mares, the world champion, said, after the sixth round is when we will see if those body shots really pay off for Lucas Matisse. Left hook, looping right hand, another left hook, another right hand, and Soto is hurt, and he goes down with the right hand. Can he get up? Wow! Matisse! Humberto Soto barely gets up to get out of the round.
All right. Get some air. Get some air. How are you feeling? How are you feeling? Look at me. Look at me. How are you feeling? Give him air. Give him air. Take a deep breath. Let's stop the fight. Let's stop the fight. We're going to stop the fight. He's going to stop the fight. I'm going to stop the fight.
And they stop it. Lucas Matisse said he was not going to allow the judges to decide the outcome of this.
Do what no one's done before, and that is knock out Humberto Soto. An overhand right will be the big one. There's the punch that started the trouble for Soto. And that's the signature punch for Matisse. And yet another one sends him back. Then he was able to land yet a third. And had that third not been able to land, Soto might have been able to weather that at least to get through the round. But the third one landed. And when you're hit with three straight power punches from Lucas Matisse, you go down. But for a couple of glitches on the scorecards, Lucas Matisse would probably be undefeated right now, and some would argue should be undefeated, saying that he beat Judah and Alexander. Raul Caiz sent him back to the corner after that, but he would not be able to answer the bell. Again, we take a look at the overhand rights by Matisse. He knew that Soto was in trouble, and he was able to get him down. Soto would beat the count, but Raul Caiz knew that they were at the end of the round, and so he sent him to the corner where Soto's people hoped that 1 minute would give him enough time. But Ebner, as we look at it again, these overhand rights, they're hard to stop when they're thrown like that and thrown with such power.
They are, really. That's one of my favorite punches, actually.
You do throw that, yes.
I like that punch. You don't see it coming. You don't see it coming. It's not a straight punch. It's an overhand right. You don't see it coming, but that definitely that straight right hand that dropped Soto right now, that was it. That was he actually bounced back from the ropes and got caught with that right hand.
This young man has really had a long road to get to this point, Gus.